The Philippines' merchandise exports surged by 15.7% in February 2024. That translates to $5.9 billion, up from $5.1 billion the previous year. The Trade Department attributes this growth to the robust upturn in the semiconductor industry, which it said grew by nearly 32%. The Philippines' top export markets are the U.S., Hong Kong, China, South Korea, and the Netherlands. The Philippine government is hopeful this growth momentum will be sustained in the coming months. Here's our numbers that matter today. The Philippines expects to generate 489 million pesos in sales from this year's ITB Travel Trade Fair in Berlin. The Tourism Promotions Board touts this is doable than last year's negotiated sales revenue of 271 million pesos. The annual event at the German capital saw the participation of dozens of travel companies and tour operators from the Philippines. Tourism Secretary Cristina Frascos welcomed the higher sales leads. In a statement, she said this speaks of the government and the private sector's commitment to boosting tourism development in the country.
Philippine energy officials seeing more stable energy supply today, that's Wednesday. The Energy Department said some power plants in Luzon and Visayas that went into forced outage are now back online. Despite this, the power grids of Luzon and Visayas remain under yellow alert as demand for electricity remains high due to the scorching heat.
Ang nagpalala lang po ng sitwasyon natin ay ito pong bigla ang pagkakaroon ng outage or emergency shutdown ng Pagbilao power plants kung saan po dalawang units nila ang nawala sa serbisyo dahil po sa pagkakaroon ng tinatawag nating boiler tube leak.
The National Grid Corporation of the Philippines, for its part, says it expects the peak demand for power next month. The NGCP calling for a holistic approach in dealing with the power issues.
We are expecting the peak demand of by mid-May.
Okay.
So we are expecting more demand for the year. We really need to approach energy planning in a holistic manner, not just transmission, but the entire industry, including generation and distribution.
The operator of the Philippines' Malampaya natural gas field says it has exceeded export capacity with the Luzon grid on alert status. Enrique Razon's Prime Energy said today gas supply to customers hit its peak at 290 million standard cubic feet per day. It said this was beyond the maximum capacity of Malampaya wells and just 262 standard cubic feet per day. Prime Energy gave the assurance it's committed to providing domestic gas supply to mitigate the impact of the grid alert scenarios. The Malampaya gas field off Palawan supplies some 20% of Luzon Island's power requirements. A check on the Philippine peso now. The local currency is still hovering at the 57 level in intraday trading, following its closing at 57 pesos to the dollar on Tuesday. This figure marks the peso's weakest level since November 2022. The peso's record low versus the greenback is at 59. The Philippine Central Bank attributes the depreciation to tensions in the Middle East and hawkish comments from the Fed. The Central Bank, however, notes it does not see these developments affecting its monetary policy so far. In its second policy meeting of the year, the BSP maintained its benchmark rate at a near 17-year high of 6.5%.